And welcome to yet another unboxing on Lenhardt Gaming. This is actually a retake because my one camera went out of battery. It's not running on a cord. So I will be unboxing Galactic Empire Conversion Kit for X-Wing 2.0. Remember, as I said with my Scum and Villainy unboxing video, this is borrowed from a friend of mine who also play X-Wing. He was so kind to lend me his conversion kit for me to unbox, because I haven't invested in them myself just yet. So in this box we will find a booklet, list of all things. We have the cardboard, the dials with tokens, a lot of them, the new design backs on the dials, more tokens, more dials, stuff we're missing, the middle part apparently, and more cardboards. Okay, so now, we have, with this, we also got more cardboards in this little, those are new pilots, and just for you to see, we have a TIE Advance, Vet Foslo, we got some TIE Fighters, Saint Marana, Del Mico, and Gideon Husk. Those are four new pilots that we haven't seen before. I think they will be in the expansion, TIE Fighter expansion. Wave 1 of 2.0. Let's start with pilots. Got patrol leader. That's the decimator. We got, of course, Girano. We've got Captain Oikun. We've got the Omnicom group pilot. Then we got the Lambda class. The Omicron was Lambda class, then Lieutenant Tsai, Colonel Jendon, and remember to look at that he got charges, not all got charges. Then we got Captain Kaki. Then we come to Cutlass Squadron Pilot, a Punisher generic. Then we have Death Rain and Redline. As you can hear, I'm not reading up all the abilities because that's a lot of talking and the video will be almost an hour. So, got generic Alpha class, new squadron pilots. We got Rogue Squadron, Lieutenant Kasabi. I'm really looking forward to this X2.0. Major Winder. Then we got Imdar test pilot for TIE Phantom, and they got Stygium Array as a title for all Phantoms. We got Sigma Squadron Ace. We've got Echo and of course Whisper. Then we got the TIE Aggressor. We've got the Xenar Specialist. The Onyx Squadron. I will just remove this. Then we got Double Edge. And we've got Lieutenant Kestal. And now for some defenders. We have Delta Squadron Pilot. And we have Onyx Squadron Ace. We've got the Countess. Colonel Vesely, Rex LaBrath, and as you can see, many of these ships got the special ability, which is tied to the ship itself. We got Planetary Sentinel, so you don't have to buy these adaptive ailerons as you should before. Then we got the Black Squadron Scout. We've got Pure Sabak. We've got Countdown, Duchess. Then we come to the Bombers. We've got Scimitar Squadron. We've got Gamma Squadron. Deathfire. Major Reimer. Captain Jonas. And the last bomber in this pack, Tomax Bren. And for the TIE Interceptors, we got Alpha Squadron Pilot. We've got Saber Squadron Ace. We've got Turfinia. We've got one of my favorites, Suntia Fell. Then for the TIE Advanced Version 1, we've got the Inquisitor. Got Force Points, a generic pilot. We've got Baron of the Empire. We've got a Seventh Sister. And we've got the Grand Inquisitor. Valen Rudor is not in this anymore, as you can see. Then we got the TIE Advanced, the normal TIE Advanced X1, Tempest Squadron Pilot, got Storm Squadron, we got Surtik Storm, we've got Marek Steel, and of course Darth Vader. We got the fiercest pilots in the TIE Fighter, the Academy pilots. We've got Obsidian Squadron Pilot. We've got Black Squadron Ace. We've got Wampa. We've got Scourge Gutu. We've got Howrunner. And we've got Mauler Mythyl. So, these were all the pilots. Now for some upgrade cards. We'll start with some talents. Marksmanship. We've got Outmaneuver. As you can see, the cards are big. When we held the event, we got Predator. When we held the event, release event, we found out that the cards are so big that it's kind of a little bit annoying, because they feel a lot on the table. So I think they made them too big. If you got a lot of upgrade cards on a ship, this will be almost half the table on one side. So yeah, we've got Ruthless. You need to make your own impression, of course. Then we've got Lone Wolf. We have Duke. We have Intimidation. We have Expert Handling. We've got Elusive. We've got Debris Gambit. Daredevil, multi. We have Crackshot. And got Gonk Droids as a pilot, crew member. Then we got the Grand Inquisitor as a crew now. We've got Grand Moff Tarkin. We've got the Informant. This is where you get this, the listening device. Then we have Minister Tua, another one from Star Wars Rebels. We got Moff Gergerard. Then we got Novice Technician. Then we got Perceptive Copilot. I will just so you can see that a bit. And then I will remove it. Then we got Seasoned Navigator. We've got Seven Sister as a crew also. Got it in the TIE Advanced version 1. Then we've got some tactical officers. Then we got a gunner, a fifth brother. A gunner that gives you force points. Then we got the hotshot gunner. We've got a skilled bombardier. We've got a veteran turret gunner. Okay. We've got a bomblet generator. We've got Connor Net. 1, 2, 3. We've got proton bombs. Got 3 of those. We've got proximity mines. 3 of those. We've got seismic charges. 3 of those. A lot of 3 of those. Then 2 of these. Ablative plating. Then we got advanced slam. Requires slam, of course, before you can check this card. Electronic baffle. Then we have hull upgrade. There are 2 of those. 2 of electronic baffle. Then we have munitions failsafe. We've got shield upgrade, static discharge vanes, we've got stealth device, we've got tactical scrambler, and now for some titles, Dauntless, ST321, and 3 of these, OS1 Arsenal Loadout, for the Alpha Class Starwing, and 3 of XG1 Assault Configuration for the same ship. Okay. Next up, we have Saturation Salvo. We've got Squad Leader. We've got Swarm Tactics. We've got 3 trick shots. We've got 2 advanced sensors. We've got 2 collision detectors. I'm really looking forward to this because some of the cards are not difficult to understand. We've got fire control system. And we got the charges. I'm looking forward to that. And like this one, trajectory simulator. Basically the same as before. You launch a bomb. Then we got the heavy laser cannon. Range 2 to 3. The same one. And then we got iron cannon. You can use that at range 1 and get the extra die. Then we got jamming beam. Then we got tractor beam. All these you can use as at range 1 and get the extra die. It's only if there is a little missile logo down here. That's when you can't use it at range 1. Oh, of course you can use it if the range at range 1, but you won't get the bonus. The dorsal turret. Then we got the iron cannon turret. Then we got advanced protons, torpedoes. Then we got ion torps. And then we got proton torpedoes. Then we got something new. Oh, I heard the name Barrage Rockets. Aren't they new? I can't remember. You see the little missile sign besides the range? That means that you won't get range 1 bonus if it was at range 1. And now it's 2 to 3, so. But this one, you will get an extra die. at range 1. Yeah, you will not get an extra die at range 1 because of the missile logo. If it had been without the little missile logo, you would get the range 1 bonus. We've got concussion missiles. We've got homing missiles. We've got ion missiles. Three of these. Nearly three of all missiles. Then we got proton rockets. Prockets, as we call them. Then we got Admiral Sloan. Imperial only. Then we got Agent Kallus. And he will be using this. Then you will get 100. And as you can see on his card, you may change one focus result to a hit. Then we got Sienna Ri. We've got, of course, Darth Vader. And then we get Emperor Palpatine. And then I have here the last two cards. They are right here. It is Freelance Slicer. So, this was a fast walkthrough of the cards in the Imperial conversion kit. There are a lot of cards, a lot of named cards that you know, especially crew members. So hope you like this video, and this is somewhat a new method of unboxing for me, at least. I hope that you can see the cards, that they are clearly on your screen. So may the force be with you. Remember to have fun, fly casual. Remember to subscribe somewhere down here, over there, I think it is, or is it over there? Don't know. Subscribe to my channel, comment my videos, and like my videos. So may the force be with you. Have fun. Support your communities. Support your local stores with X-Wing 2.0. And let's have some great tournaments around Europe. And I'm looking forward to participate at least in Denmark. So see you soon. And bye.